Oh, good. APR sees me. Oh, I need my tablet. That's important. There we go. All right. So, hello, Internet. Camera was a little off center because I was trying to frame the room differently last night. Hi. It is 2:11 p.m. on Monday, May 16th, 2022. I'm Mark Amsrai, DJ Amstrak, and I'm holding court here on the Throne of Games. On Friday, I got most of the way through Jotun. Well, most of the rest of the way through Jotun. I started it properly on Wednesday. Got through the first two stages. Or maybe it was just the first one. And then the rest of the stages up to what I think is the final boss on Friday. That was Odin, and he was giving me a hell of a time. So, now, as you can see in the title down below, I think that's where it shows up. Yeah, I just learned that you can attack the spears he throws, the Gungnir, and that's how you're supposed to avoid them. I was trying to dodge them because they have a limited turning radius, so I was trying to dodge in a way that was quicker than they could turn, and that was making it way harder than it needed to be. Should definitely just use lightning against Odin. If only I had enough. If only. Magic is a very limited commodity in this game. Which, I mean, is fair. I'm not a wizard. I'm a Viking. What magic I have is a blessing from the gods. So, let's get to it. Probably
Thor,
have to
dreiðin var
work on the timing of
smánarlegur.
hitting the
Númerið þitt og
spears, but
brautsigla hafa leitt þig langan veg. Í þessu gapandi tómi hefur þú ferðast öll ríkin, fundið rúnirnar, sigrað jötnana. Það var ég, Óðinn, sem gaf þér annað tækifæri þar eð blóð Þórs flæðir æðar þínar. Láttu þessa miklu gjöf aðstoða þig í loka bardaga þínum, þar sem ég, alfaðirinn, mun vera loka óvinur þinn. Búðu þig undir bardaga, Þóra. Ekki mistakast að ávinna þér hylli goðana.
Okay, I was too slow to attack that time. I need to swing earlier. Earlier still. Dodged right into that one. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, I missed that one. Snuck up on me. mid animation on that one. Yeah, oof. Okay. I'm learning though. I got this. Yeah. Okay, I'm starting to feel more badass now. No recovering from the roughness of that start, but oh god! Phew! That one's... When they come up from the bottom of the screen, they're a bit harder to deal with. Dang it. Yeah. Damn it.
Dear Heaven, mistake is overwhelming.
Okay, well, I got him. Got him past the first stage, only using healing with that technique, I think. too slow on that one. Damn it. Okay, that rune spooked me. Oop. Ow. I think I dodged in the wrong direction for that one. I'm in a bad place. I'm in a very bad place. Damn it. Oh, and I died. No Gungnir for you. He swung a little late, but he missed, so. Just did that one, damn it. Eh. Oh God. Late on that one. Oh, oh. No fair. Oh. Wish I had a quicker way of calling up each of those abilities, though. You know? Like the crossbar in FF14, or cross hotbar. Rather than having to just cycle through them and be aware of my position. Damn it! Ah, hell. Should be so easy to avoid. Oh, I'm in a very bad place. Oh, damn it! No! Oh, jeez. Nope, this is... damn it. Too many things converging on me at once. Like, and I died, damn it! I got greedy. Was around. Oh, that's bad. Damn it. There too, jeez. Oh, jeez, everything hit me at once. Thank you. God. And I careless. Thank you. Got him. Greeted it right at the last minute, so I didn't have to deal with all those mechanics at once. Valkyries.
Kom þú, víkingur, og sættu verðlunin.
Það var ég sem ferðaðist ginnungaga og naut blessunar goðanna. Það var ég sem sigraði jötnana í stórfenglum bardögum. Og sannaði mig fyrir óðunni að ég ávinna mér sæti í Valhöll. Ég Þóra í Jötnabali.
That was cool. Like, that was a simple ending, but it was hard enough earned that I have goosebumps. It's been a moment since it scrolled past, but thinking about it, it makes a lot of sense that they picked Reykjavik to record the voices in, because the Icelandic language is one of the Nordic is part of the Nordic family of languages. But it's the closest to the old Viking tongue, closer than Norwegian, Swedish, or Danish. Those three got influenced by each other, and Slavic languages to the east and Germanic languages to the south. Whereas in Iceland, they remained relatively isolated, at least, you know, in where they lived. They were Vikings. They traveled all over the place, but that isolation led to somewhat more linguistic preservation, basically. I think that's interesting. Kind of sweaty from that tense fight. Not like working up a sweat, just, you know, the anxiety of it. need to figure out what I'm going to play next. I don't think I can alt-tab without pausing the scroll or the music. But it's in the long list of backers, so I could just get up and go take a look at my shelf, see if anything from the from my PS2 shelf jumps out at me. Or, you know, any of the other systems that I can emulate. Let's see. I do not feel up to Valhalla mode. Thank you, but that was enough challenge for me. I liked how Odin would just walk around while you were attacking him, like you didn't actually matter. I mean, he is a god, you know. He is a god, and he was testing me, so it makes sense that he would want to give me a fighting chance. So anyway, I've come across a handful of options, which two of them will definitely require some de-jankifying because they're old PC games. So, given that, I'm going to look up some information and see what I can find. the one that would be the simplest to move on to right now and would be thematically connected with Jotun here is Odin's Sphere, which I've never beaten or really gotten all that far in. It's a difficult game. But it's so pretty. It is so, so pretty. And I mean, it's Vanillaware. Is that the name of the studio, I think? I'm not sure if it is. There are used stickers covering the spots that might have that information. Let's check the manual. Is it Vanillaware? Jeez, all the credits just appear to be Atlas related. And like, I know they're the publishers, but they're like, Well, anyway. It's super pretty. I'm just not entirely sure that that's what I want to do next. There is a very silly old Sierra adventure game that I adore called Torrens Passage. But the last time I attempted to play it, which wasn't even on a recent computer. Like, yeah, the last time I attempted to play it was probably about 12 or 14 years ago. So on a computer that old, and it was made for like Windows 95. I remember having to like, what did I do? There was like one time that I tried to play it on a Windows 98 computer. This was like before they had Windows had its built-in compatibility mode, whatever. And I had to go through and like actually turn the computer's graphical settings down because it would not launch unless the system was in 256 color mode. I am going to see if there is any information on getting that one. Did I say what game it was? Torrens Passage. I know I said it was a Sierra adventure game. No, not walkthroughs. Oh, is there only one R in it? All this time, I thought it was two. What is that, PC Games Wiki? PC Gaming Wiki. There we are. I don't think I've streamed this before. I should double check to be sure because I don't want to like redo a thing. Games.blogspot.com. Search. Okay, I mentioned Torin's passage once in the blog for the game introduction on King's Quest VII. This game, Torin's passage came pretty closely after King's Quest VII. So it's got a very similar but more refined style. Like like, if they were figuring things out in King's Quest VII, they had them figured out when they made Torin's Passage. Wait, it works with ScumVM? Well, you know what? That'll be a nice, fun, short thing. I think I'll at least try and get it running.
That's that thing. I remember that. That might be fun to do too.
If I can get it to work. It was an old Magic the Gathering PC game made by MicroProse that I had a lot of fun with as a kid. It was built around 4th edition, I think. Yeah, okay, apparently this should work with ScumVM. That's cool. Anyway. Ooh, isn't it pretty? The back is just an ad for another Sierra game. Honestly, I love the color of that disc. That is a pretty color. That kind of royal blue, deep purple thing going on. I mean, I don't really know much about today's Magic, honestly. I haven't kept up with it in a... but my most recent cards, I think, are from 2016. and I don't have very many of those. All right, let's Oh no! I forgot I don't have a CD-ROM drive! Oh no! Which means that this is kind of off the table too. Oh boy. Okay, you know what? I have other computers with CD-ROM drives. I can rip an image and just move it from computer to computer. That'll work, but it'll take a while, so I'm just gonna call it good for today. We beat a game. That's enough of a stream. So let's see who's around to raid. Steve is playing Going Under. Let's say hey to him. So yeah, I'll be back Wednesday with probably Torin's Passage, unless I change my mind. Oh, the other, if you were curious, the other PC game that I have over there that I was curious to see if I could get working was Phantasy Star Universe, which I only played like that much of at the time because its requirements, its system requirements were a bit higher than my system could handle. So like the frame rates were painful. It might not have quite been unplayable, but it was unwatchable. So anyway, yeah, let's go say hey to Steve, and I'll see you next time. Later, everybody.